guys, like, do you ever look this pretty and decide to yes, I am pretty and people need to see me, so I'm gonna vlog, but you have no idea of why you are vlogging. That is me today.
Our funniest moments, I told you this is Christian content. So yeah, funny moments. I apologize for the cars passing. Like, so when I'm seeing those snacks, I mean, it's a car wash. That's what happens. Much like never thought. I mean, it's a car wash. Abu Prada.
Abu Prada. One of the funniest moments with George on it. Abu Prada. One time, one guy, Abu Prada.
Okay, you need a funny moment there, cause I'm crazy.
I know.
Guys, we're Elijah. This one.
Why
don't we be? He was welcoming like visitors in our church, and there was a brother called Aquila. Umuntu yamenza ni pronunciation.
Aquila.
But yeah, wanna be there. My funniest moment, it's actually not inside of the church.
Yeah.
it was in the morning we were preparing to go to church,
and.
So, well, yesterday they had requested this other brother to accommodate us in his house. And then now in the morning he's coming to check on us. So when he gets there, he's like, are you guys all right? And then we're like, yeah, we're all right. He says, do you have transport? Obviously he has a car. He says, do you have transport? Well, we understood that he has a transport. But someone did not understand that guy has a transport. And then he replied, no. We have a transport, it's a van. You can go now. So it's only this one. I have a new sponsor move.
I'm not a married brother.
I'm not a lassel.
We're like shit.
Becomes a funny moment for you guys.
There's
no way you can't see another
one. Yeah. Guys, every time I see you convincing and those would be testing us one by one that you did this. And it was not okay. When you did this, it was not okay. Why in telecom?
What happened? Yeah, what happened? Why is he? Why is he?
He has received some. He can only manage his life.
Let's have a meaningful conversation next.
Yes.
So as Kulmeni, things we wish we knew.
People are people. They have their flaws. Don't angelize everyone.
Oh, yeah.
They are the children of God, but they are not perfect, right? So know that one. Because if you sort of make them Superman and then sin, there's what you get disappointed, get hurt.
Yeah, and also you need to remember, as much as in a city, we are We are the creation ya kankulunkulu ne. Everyone else is a creation of kankulunkulu. So as much as when I'm always beggar, we want to know, I need to be kind to myself, I'm gonna make mistakes and all of that. That's how you should treat everyone else, because now they are gonna make mistakes, they are people.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, they are the creation of kankulunkulu like Nisho.
Yeah.
So yeah. What did you learn?
Me, I've learned as a Christian, you shouldn't be judging. I mean, you shouldn't like spiritualize everything and like.
Guys, my lessons, no mugua. Like, what's going on?
Like, yeah.
Spiritualizing everything. You see people like including scriptures, Bible, reading the Bible. I was still judging it. Person will be reading a Bible and then they don't want to engage in like conversations. Like, you see, he said do not spiritualize everything. Let me put this like this. There are conversations that we need to talk about, because at the end of the day we are human. Don't spiritualize everything. You want to talk about scriptures, quotes and everything. No.
In short, at some point, in the world.
Let me tell you this. Because some people are looking at Christians, they are like, this person went some mistake, this person went some mistake. At the end of the day, what's up? What's happening?
Okay, nice, okay.
Okay, at the end of the day, we are in Christ. If we make our mistakes, the Bible says that He perfects us. So we are in Him.
Hallelujah.
So He is able to stand for us. If you are not in Him, we gotta get into Christ. I just turned that thing to a whole sermon right there.
But it's okay, that's what we want, that's what we are here for.
Sure,
what did you learn? Oh.
I would like to quote from our South African, our own product, Skumba Shop.
But guys, but also that goes back to the point that Ndo and I were making. We tell them that we are not perfect. Ndo, let me see you. Sure.
I think it's all
that. Okay, let me start. I wish we think I'm making as routine. Like when you surrender to God. When you surrender to God, like things start to fall into place when you surrender. Yeah? But the moment you be zulu and kulunkulu, like you feel like the more you don't wanna obey or the more you don't wanna trust God and all of that, that's when kulunkulu is okay, we'll see. Because at the end of the day, I'm the one who has the power and I'm the one who's in control of your life. So if you don't wanna trust me, we'll see who you're paying up. But the moment you're like, yes, kulunkulu, this is you, do whatever you want. Like you feel like that's where things start to fall into place. And I need to keep Bible actually. Blessed is the man that trusted in God. So the moment you start trusting, the moment you start surrendering, everything just starts to make sense. So if you are sitting there and you are busy fighting, that is one battle that you are going to lose. It's not going to work. Just surrender and enjoy your blessings, because they are going to come the moment you start trusting God and surrendering. So yeah, that is me.
You listen, man.
Yep.
Man, you didn't say a thing.
Man.
Yo, what have you learned?
A lot of things, actually. A lot. I'm still learning even now.
Yeah, but yes, what's that one thing that stands out?
Yeah, the one that you want to share.
That one thing you would tell Umuntu Figa Ngondwen, or Umuntu who's still trying to build a relationship with God.
Okay, the first thing I would say is, don't expect, the very same people overthrow the message, Babi Ngendlela overthrowing the message.
Okay.
Like if for example, for example, uthole mina ku message first day, ngalendlela le mingayo you nice friendly, but then mawuqala ungena ku message uzisisa ukuthi akusinjalo kahle
nethi. Okay, you need to understand that things are bound to change.
Yeah.
That's what you mean. Things will always change. And
hallelujah.
People always change. Okay.
And ungakontrol
lento ibone ekuqaleni
ukuthi ke kusola. Okay, now guys, I think I know what he means, ne? So I'm going to No, guys, mina ngicabanga ukuthi what he means is that because the thing is when we are men in Lima. The thing is when like we are Christians, ne? And you are still new, you are bound to idolize some other people.
Yes.
There are people that you're gonna look at and think, no, over. So whatever he does, it goes. Because when in your head you think this person is perfect, so you need to understand that is bound to change. No moment are you true worship or whatnot. He is gonna get tested at some point. He is gonna fail some tests. He is gonna pass others. So when you should not. It's not gonna work.
Okay, Mina, what I've learned is, ne, when you go to any church, or actually, okay, the message, ne, guys, is, Uguti, don't lean on people. Don't lean on people. Don't lean on people.
Hey, don't lean on others.
Yes,
you
do not.
The moment ud umuntu sokwakwata lokulokhile like kuwa mina kwata yena because they were leaning on me and it's not fair. You guys, that's such a huge responsibility. Yeah. Like
can I say something profound? Okay,
continue.
Obviously, this is the moment.
Yeah,
actually I'm a student. Okay, number one, I want to say this. Please understand me properly. Number one, we are not friends in the message. We are not in the message to be friends.
As much as we are friends, as much as we have gotten closer and became a family, so the moment you want to separate our friendship from that,
If
you get into church and then you are able to build a strong relationship with those people and you become a family, it's a bonus, like it's a blessing, fine, it's great.
Yeah.
But do not get tangled up in that to such a point where you forget why you are in church in the first place. More about your guys, like friends will betray you, whether they are in church or not. So the moment you mix that with God, then it's going to be a fail.
There are three kinds of believers.
Amen.
So what he said, it applies.
Yeah.
Unbeliever, make believer, and true believer. And then you find these in every church that you are going to go to, in every house of the Lord, there are those three kinds of believers. You know? So hence the Bible says this, says that to some, the Lord Jesus is going to say that, depart from me, I never knew you. How could he say to those, because they'll reply and say, Lord, we did this for you. How can you not know us? He'll still say, depart from me. So
Amen.
You can understand that those people were in church.
Yes.
So if you do come in church and then you make friendship, that's a bonus,
yeah,
as I said. I'm just adding to that one.
So,
and then don't fall because your friend in church did this and that and that.
Yeah.
Or don't start doing things just because your friend is doing them. To say that, she has a boyfriend, he has a girlfriend.
Yeah.
I can do that as well. Hey, like,
stay in your lane, stay in the word.
Yeah.
Regardless.
Important, you know.
Yes.
Why
are
you
begging us? No, this video. Bye, guys. Bye bye, Foza, man. Hey, man. See you guys.
Hey, peace.
Bye, Nels. Thank you, guys.